Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Fardina Siska. Today I will presentation about speech act, locution, illocution, dan perlocution. The Oxford philosopher J. Austin started his 9 lecture published in his book How to Do Things with Words by a contrasted statement about formative and constative utterance, mentioning that the truth or falsity of a statement depends not merely on the meaning of word, but on what act you were performing and what circumstance this represents. The gift of what would be known as speech act theory. Speech act theory, which was foreshadowed by the Aus philosopher Ludwig Wittgenstein's view about language games, were performed by Austin in the late 1930s and presented in his lectures given in Oxford in 1952 until 1954, and later in his William James lectures delivered at Harvard in 1955. After his death in 1960, Austin's ideas were refined, systematized, and advanced, especially by his Oxford, the American philosopher John Searle. Definition of speech act. Searle hypothesized that speaking a language is an engineering in a rural government form of behavior in which this form is performing speech acts such as making statements, giving comments, asking questions, and making promises. Speech act theory is essentially concerned with the communicative function of utterance in terms of what the speakers aim to achieve by virtue of speaking and in terms of the resulting effect on the addresses by Perkins and by Cruz defines speech act as act which crucially involves the production of language. A speech act is an utterance that serves a function in communication. Austin theory of speech act. Austin in 1962 claimed that all utterance, in addition to meaning whatever they mean, perform specific acts via the specific communicative force of an utterance. He introduced a threefold distinction among the acts one simultaneous performs when saying something, how to do things with word theory, locutionary, illocutionary, and perlocutionary. First, locutionary. It is the production of an utterance with a particular intended structure, meaning a reference, the literal meaning of actual word. Lee, in 1983, defines locutionary act as roughly equivalent to uttering a certain sentence with a certain sense and reference. The locutionary act is the act of saying something with a certain meaning and reference. So, it has to do with what is said in a sense by linking reference with prediction about those reference. Number two, illocutionary. The illocutionary act deals with what you intend to do by means of saying it. We have the illocutionary act, which acts in the intention of the speaker regarding what act they intended to perform by means of making the utterance by Birner in 2012. An act is performed by a speaker in saying something with an appropriate intention and in appropriate context, rather than by virtue of producing a particular effect with saying something. Number three, perlocutionary. It is speech act which depends on the production of specific effect the hearer performs. Acting behavior does not necessarily mean getting the hearer to do physical movement. It is also deals with the change of thought or habit of the hearer. This statement it is aligned with Yule in 1996, who point out the perlocutionary acts bring the so-called perlocutionary effect when a speaker feels sad about being left out. The difference is locution, the words that are uttered or written, illocution, the speaker's or reader's intention, and perlocution, the intended effect or response. Example, the window is open. Could you close it, please? Locution, mention, the window is open. Illocution, attention, request sentence. Perlocution, effect, the window closed. The problem could happen in every utterance. They might have different meaning, which can make the hearer cannot recognize the real elocutionary force from the utterance. There are two ways to answer this: I fit and felicity condition. I fit, elocutionary force indicating device, an expression from an utterance which contains a slot to put a verb that explicitly name the elocutionary act being performed. They explicitly describe their utterance elocutionary act by using us and tell as performative verb. I fit can be identified as a word order, stress, and intonation. She's going, I tell you. She is going, I request confirmation. Is she going, I ask you. Felicity condition. To make the utterance can be recognized by the hearer, the circumstance surrounding the speaker must be appropriate with the condition. Example, I sentence you to 6 months in prison. The performance won't be appropriate if the speaker is not a specific person in special context. In this case, the speaker must be a judge in a courtroom. Sentry condition requires that the speaker is sincere in uttering the declaration. Example, promise is only effective when the speaker really intends to carry it out. Speech act classification. Further development by John Searle classifies speech act into 5 main categories: directive, assertive or expressive, commissive, expressive, and declaration. First, directive. The speaker requests the hearer to carry out some action or bring about some state of affairs, such as order, command, insist, suggest, request, ask, beg, plead, pray, entreat, permit, and advise. Example, please close the window. Assertive or representative. The purpose is to convey information about some state of affairs of the world from the speaker to the hearer, such as boasting, complaining, claiming, diagnosing, concluding, stating, classifying, characterizing, asserting. Example, it is very hot today. Commissive, the purpose is to show that the speaker undertakes something by expressing an intention, such as promise, pledge, threat, or any other words that match the criteria of commissive. Example, I will come to the party tomorrow. For expressive, the purpose is to bring up about some state of affairs by the more performance of the speech act or referral the speaker's state of mind about a situation, such as apologies, welcome, thanks, congratulate, console, or other words that match with expressive. Example, thank you, I'm very happy with this gift. The last is declarative. The purpose is where the speakers bring about some state of affairs by the more performance of the speech act or aim to create a change, such as resign, appoint, declare name, call, define, nominate. Example, I declare this meeting is open. Direct and indirect speech act. For example, she plants a mango tree. Declarative statement. Does she plant a mango tree? Interrogative question. Plant a mango tree. Imperative comment or request. There is an easily recognized relationship between three structural forms: declarative, integrative, imperative, and three general communication functions: statement, question, comment, or request. Direct speech is a direct relationship between a structure and function, and indirect speech is an indirect relationship between a structure and a function. Direct and indirect speech act. We have known that a declarative sentence as a function as a statement, so we call it direct speech. But if the declarative sentence used to be a request, we call it indirect speech act. For example, it is cold outside. I heard Herbie tell you about the weather. I heard Herbie request of you that you close the door. The utterance A is declarative. If we use it, make a statement as paraphrase. In B, it is functioning as a direct speech. And meanwhile, if the A is to make a comment or request as a paraphrase, in C, it is functioning as an indirect speech. Thank you very much.